FDTV presents Gentle Giant with Pam Minnick and Katie Kaufman.
This week, we take a look back at our travels this year. We covered the U.S. to bring you a variety of stories about heavy horses, literally from coast to coast.
That's right, Pam. From the extreme West Coast, we began the year under the tall pine trees in Grass Valley, California, and ended 3,000 miles to the east near Washington, D.C.
We covered everything from shiny six-horse hitches to heavyweight pulls, logging, and plowing. The best of Gentle Giants begins in just a moment. Welcome back to Gentle Giants. Grass Valley, California sits at the foothills of the Sierra Nevada Mountains, and the arena is nestled among the tall ponderosa pines.
The Draft Horse Classic is held in a community that embraces Gentle Giants, as the large bronze welcomes you to the fairgrounds.
The Classic spotlights a variety of heavy horse breeds, teams, rigs, and performances, featuring everything from farm wagons and carriages to intricate driving competitions, delighting fans with their pageantry, elegance, and strength. With six performances over 4 days, Sally Seamus explains that each performance is finely timed and coordinated, with the convenience of the exhibitor and the excitement of the fans in mind. She's been the show coordinator for more than 2 decades, and her responsibilities are diverse.
Stalling the horses, taking the entries, putting them together so that they aren't back to back in their classes, hiring the acts, putting the acts in between each class. It's one of the most outstanding draft shows on the West Coast. The judges that come here from Canada and back east tell us they haven't seen one quite like it because it's geared towards the audience and not the people that are taking place. It's not just a horse show, it's more of a production.
Dave and Patsy Cunningham's Meadow Lake Belgian Hitch was named Teamster of the Year. They love the Grass Valley Show.
The atmosphere of this particular fairground and the ambiance that they create for everyone, it's fantastic. And the announcers are always wonderful. They always give a great color to the show. Like no show we've ever gone to. I mean, it's gorgeous. We're up here in the foothills of the Sierras. I don't know what the elevation is, but it's hot up there among all these ponderosa pine. And the barns are all nestled in there. I think they planted it around the trees, so they're very conscious of the aesthetics of it. The crowd is just phenomenal. I mean, I don't think we've any show, except maybe Calgary, do they get on the West Coast, do they get a crowd like this? I think I heard something like 20,000 people over the 3 days or 4 days that this goes on. It's just amazing.
From California, we headed to the National Western Stock Show in Denver, Colorado, where this year's North American Six Horse Hitch Classic Series Finals was held.
It's a real challenge for the final four hitches in three breeds, as January is a tough time to keep a shiny hair coat on those beautiful horses.
It's an honor to be here, and we're, I guess, one of the lowest budget hitches here probably, but I guess that's what makes it better when you do good. The lead team is Cody and Shadow. We've had them now, I think this is our fifth season with them. I guess they really taken care of us over the years. They're best lead team we could have ever asked for. Swing team is Randy and Mark. I guess they're always there and do their job. And wheel team, we've got a young one in there that we raised, Jason. And on the other side is Lance. And we just picked him up last year, and he's really working out well. they really drive hard. I mean, they're always there and always wanting to go. I mean, they're probably one of the fastest going hitches, and all we got to do is hold them under control, I guess.
We try to keep the hitch together as much as we can, but just like an athletic club, we're always jockeying to get the best team that we can together. We just added a new horse in. The wheel of our hitch, which is in the back. This is the first show on our team for him. So it's kind of a big show to come into, but he has had some experience in the show ring in the past, so it's not a whole new ball game for him. It's exciting. We try to put the best group of horses together that we can hope that it will culminate in the blue ribbon. These horses are performance athletes, so just like any other athlete, yeah, you want to take good care of their health and their body. With this particular horse, we stretch out his front legs and keep his shoulders nice and loose because he tends to get tight in his shoulders. So we try to go through all the horses and just make sure that they're performing at their top level.
And this year's North American Six Horse Hitch Classic Series champion was Wilderness Ridge Farms Belgians of Sagola, Michigan, with Bud Miller at the lines.
I knew my horses performed all three nights the way I wanted them to. We had three good drives, but the level of competition is so high at this point that it's cross your fingers and hope for the best. I felt that the horses performed to the top of their level. We were training them for this all season, chasing points to come here, and we did what we dreamed to do for a whole season, so we're very excited.
When Gentle Giants returns, we'll see heavy horses at work. Stay with us.
Welcome back to Gentle Giants. The Oklahoma State Fair was the first draft horse overload pull that we covered.
And we found that this was a very different look for heavy horses, but a group of passionate owners.
The draft horse is used for many different occasions today, but I think it's very important we remember the main thing. The draft horse was useful because of his strength, and that's one thing we want to remember today, and that's why we're here. The horse will have a chance to show that he is very strong and he has a lot of capabilities with the power he does possess. So years and years ago, our forefathers took a lot of pride in seeing who had the strongest horse or the strongest team, and that tradition follows through today. These owners and drivers that will be competing here today take that same pride in having a top team and a team that they can count on to give them their very best when they ask them to pull and it's necessary for them to show their strength.
We've grown up with it. Both of our grandparents pulled, both of our grandfathers pulled, and that's how we met and started dating and got married. So it's just something that we've always enjoyed, and that's what we like to do together. So we don't take normal vacations, we come to horse pulls.
Then we headed to Arthur, Nebraska, where we witnessed Craig Haythorne feeding his herds on his huge operation.
That's right, Pam, with a beautiful team of six-up Belgians, and this is truly a lost practice.
My husband Craig was born 100 years too late, I think, but he still loves feeding with the teams of horses. And just a few years ago, we were feeding with way more teams every morning. I think at one time they'd harness about 50 some head each morning. But Craig continues to feed with the teams and loves that part of it and the heritage of it and just the nostalgia of that. It is very efficient, and it's a wonderful way to watch and how they can make these horses work.
My boys say it's too slow, but I'm usually not very far behind them and feeding the same amount of cows. But I mean, that's just modern generation, but I still love to feed with a team. I just love a horse, whether it's a draft horse or a quarter horse or whatever he is. We're right in the middle of calving season, and I feed with six horses, and basically the way we feed, the only place probably in the United States they ever fed that way was in the sand hills, because they were primarily haystacks in the sand hills for years until everybody went to big round bales. Now they had stacks or ricks a lot in Colorado or Wyoming, and they loaded it off of the stacks or ricks, but we pull the stacks on with the horses. To my knowledge, it is the only place in the United States where people fed that way, and there's only about three of us left that are still feeding that way.
RFD TV's Gentle Giants $100,000 Invitational raised the bar for six horse hitch competition.
We'll show you the highlights when Gentle Giants returns.
Welcome back to Gentle Giants. RFD TV's Patrick Gotch is truly a visionary. Nearly 15 years ago, he founded this network.
Then when he got the draft horse bug with this show, Gentle Giants, he took things to a new level, offering a $100,000 payout in Mesquite, Texas at the American.
Judging. Yesterday was round one. We don't know what those scores were. There were three judges. They'll be sealed along with today's scores, and that's how today's champion and that $100,000 will be distributed. We're taking a look at Blue Ribbon Days, and let's tell you a little bit more about them. These Percheron mares are world champions. At the wheel, those big girls, that's Emily and Unique, and you met Albert Cleedy, one of the owners, yesterday, and when he says the word Unique, he gets tears in his eyes. He truly loves that mare.
And the wheel horses are the biggest set or the biggest team of the horses, and they're closest to the wagon. They're the ones that pull most of the load as well as put the brakes on if need be.
You know, you saw Dean Woodbury at the lines, and we talked about how small this arena is, and they've got to make perfectly square corners there. You see him, he's constantly moving those lines. The lines alone and the pressure on them with those horses weighs 65 pounds. By the end of this routine that they'll go through both ways the arena, his arms will be tired. We'll tell you real quickly about the swing horses, Belle and Tabby. And then out at the lead, the animated horses, and this is what the judges are looking for. Animation, ears alert. That's Crystal and Melody.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
Let's take a look at these beautiful Belgians, of course, from Sagola, Michigan. They say, when you ask them where Sagola is, they say it's 100 miles from Lambeau Field. And they've got a picture in their stall area of Brett Farr, who goes hunting there, because Wilderness Ridge is a hunting facility. They've got elk and white-tailed deer on their 2,000-acre farm.
This family has been a part of heavy horses a long time.
At the lines is Bud Miller.
The Express Clydesdales.
This hitch, like you said, goes all over the place. His team is just amazing, and they are truly ambassadors for the draft horse industry. But you saw these horses yesterday. They were getting their legs all combed out, and when they comb that hair on those Clydesdales, they do it very delicately. They don't want to lose any of that beautiful feather.
That's right. Here we go.
That's Travis Shaw, the driver of Ames Percherons. We talked about them earlier being the 2012 world champions. And one of the things that's amazing about the gray Percherons is, just like people, their hair coat changes color as they get older. So one of the challenges of keeping a uniformly gray hitch together is trying to catch them when their hair coats are just at the right stage in their development. They're constantly looking for new gray horses of this caliber to pull. There's the lead team. Take a look at Hammer and Rowdy. And if they aren't spirited, I don't know what is.
On behalf of RFD TV, Mr. Patrick Gotch, presenting that magical check for $60,000.
Take a look at Travis Shaw. That meant a lot to him. This is just incredible.
Ladies and gentlemen, $60,000.
And the winner, Travis Shaw, made a lap around Cowboy Stadium. But the visit that had to have the most impact on us was our trip to Arlington National Cemetery.
That's right, Pam, where there are 61 heavy horses who have the solemn duty of carrying heroes to their final resting place.
Our horses know their jobs better than we do, but being able to work with these animals, being able to work and see the dedication that they have, not just to each other, but to the mission, they understand the solemnity of what we're doing. They will play with each other and they'll bite at each other and nip right up until the band starts playing. And once the band starts playing and the funeral has started, all seven of the horses immediately, you can feel the difference in them and they can feel the difference in their riders. But during the funerals, they are all very composed and very solemn.
They know when they're on the job. They know how to transition from when you're just walking in a cemetery to when the funeral actually starts. There's a big difference in how they react. When the funeral starts, they actually just 100% lock it up and walk real slow, walk at the pace that they're told, and they're really professional.
We use a style called ponying, in which you have two horses that they're riding controls. The near horse, usually the taller of the two, is being ridden, while the other horse back in the day would carry supplies and ammo and food, anything that the rider needed for the journey. Now it's just an off horse that helps pull the wagon.
Our rear position is our wheel riding position. They're typically reserved for our larger horses because all the braking power comes from these two horses. We also have the most experienced rider on these two horses. Here is Ringo, and on the other side is our one mare, female horse. Her name is Babe, nicknamed Baby Girl. Next, we have our swing riding position. That's usually our new soldiers who are just coming from our training class get put on this position. It's the least experienced rider, and their main job is turning. So when we make a left turn, they'll swing to the right to make it as wide as possible, because as you can see, it's quite a length to make a turn. Next, we have the lead riding position. Their main job is to maintain pace count behind the funeral procession. We go off a 21 pace count behind the chaplain during the funeral.
Thank you.
want to thank all of you for watching Gentle Giants this week and truly coming with us throughout our journey of our season.
And a special thank you to Patrick Gotch and Joe Ricketts for their vision. It's really shined a big spotlight on the draft horse industry. We'll be back with you next week right here on Gentle Giants.
And in the meantime, as always, you can check us out on Facebook.
Bye now.